In this video, we're going to build a dynamic page in Editor X that showcases the detail of our portfolio items. Let's go. Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer. This video is part three of a series where we're building a beautiful, dynamic, and complete web design portfolio with Editor X. In our last video, we created our portfolio index page that showed a list of all of our portfolio items that pulled from the Content Manager, which is Editor X's database feature that lets you create dynamic websites. Now, we also used the Velo Dev mode to create an alternating layout based on the even and odd items. Special shout out to Ido from World of Editor X for helping me figure that out. Make sure to check out his channel as well. Now, by the end of this video, we're gonna have our portfolio detail page where when you click on an item from a portfolio index, it'll open that detail page and show all of the information and context of that specific portfolio item. Let me show you how it's done. So here we can see our portfolio page that we created in our previous video, and it does have dynamic elements to it. We can manage our content right here, as you can see, but what we want is to have an index page and a detail page. So we're gonna select the three dots, convert this to a dynamic page, and we're gonna choose the collection portfolio items, which we created. It's gonna convert this to a dynamic page, and it's gonna give us two pages, an all page and a title page. The all is the index page, which shows all of the items. It's obviously not our design, so we'll have to fix that. And the title page, which is what we created. The problem here is we need a detail page, not two index pages. So let's go ahead and fix that. So I'm going to delete this page, this index page that was dynamically or automatically generated by Editor X, and we're gonna create our own. So we're left with our portfolio items index page we created. We're gonna click these three dots right here and create or add a new dynamic item page. So that's gonna create an item page for us that we can then redesign. So here we go. It's pulling in all the information for each of our items in the content manager. It doesn't match our design. We're obviously gonna fix that. But now we've got the right setup. So we've got what it looks like two items title pages. We're gonna change the name so it makes more sense. Here's our index page. We're gonna click that settings. Make sure the settings are good. We want the URL to be /portfolio. That's perfect. All right, so what I'm gonna do is gonna rename these so they make more sense to me. This is gonna be the portfolio index, displaying all the items. And this is gonna be the portfolio items. So this is the index showing the index of our portfolio pieces. And then this is the individual item template that will use this design for each of the items itself. So in the nav bar, we can't see portfolios anymore because it's no longer in the main pages. Easy fix, click on the menu, manage the menu, add a new item, choose dynamic pages, and then choose your index. Add it to your menu. You can rename that so it matches the style. Drag it to where you want it to be and preview that just to make sure. Click on portfolio. That should take us to our index page. That's perfect. Now back in the portfolio index page, these buttons need to link to those individual pieces. Now, before we hard coded a URL in our database, but there's actually dynamically generated links now. So if we go to our content manager, choose portfolio items, you can see two new fields added here, portfolio index URL here, and the portfolio items URL. Now I noticed that portfolio dash items is not the correct URL. So I'm gonna go to our index items page rather, go to our settings and take out dash items. So it should be portfolio slash and then title, the dynamically generated title from the database. All right, so that looks good. If I go back to our content manager now in our portfolio items, portfolio URLs should be /portfolio and /portfolio slash the title of the item. This URL field, we don't need it anymore. I'm gonna go and delete it. Perfect. Now we can, in our buttons on the portfolio index, I can link that to a dynamically generated URL of the items page. So I'm gonna click on that, select portfolio items title to connect it to. Now if I preview and select any of these buttons, it'll take us to its own dynamically generated page. And here we have our dynamically generated portfolio item template. Obviously, it doesn't match our design. So let's see what that looks like. Here in Figma, I can see the mockup of each of the items follows the same layout. We have a hero image at the top of the portfolio item. Below this hero image, we have some information, a two-column grid. On the left, we have the title, description, some categories, tags perhaps, a visit website button, and then we have project background with some extra information and a little gallery. So we might have to actually add a little bit to our content manager. Let's get this done. Okay, back in Editor X, I'm gonna add my pre-footer master here, make sure it's in the right area of the page. And basically, I'm gonna clear everything out here except for the next and previous buttons. So just delete everything. I'm gonna add a new blank section here, drag in an image, connect that to the image in the database. I'm gonna stretch that, add some padding around the section just to match the design. All right, next we have our content in the bottom. So I'm gonna add a new section down here and it's going to be a grid. I'm gonna make it a 2x1 grid, but I'm going to adjust its sizing of each of the columns. So I can drag that, I can be more specific, whatever works, I'm just gonna drag it. If I wanted to be specific, I can go to advanced mode and change the units of measurement here. I'm okay with this. To better match the design, I'm gonna select the grid and I'm gonna give it some left and right padding of 5%. And then I want a gap in between these two columns. So advanced mode and gaps make it 5%. And that'll do the trick. All right, now I wanna add this content. I'm gonna drag a container in this left cell, stretch it out, remove the background. Then let's just add a title, a paragraph. I'm gonna drag in our button that we designed in our assets library. And I'm also gonna add a little bit more text that we'll use for those categories or tags. All right, so now I'm just gonna do a little bit of styling here. Then I'll select all of these items and I'll make them a stack, make some even spacing in between, something like 30 pixels. I'm also gonna add those hairlines on the top and the bottom. Add them to the stack, make sure everything is evenly spaced, design those lines so they match our mockup, duplicate that, add one to the bottom, do some final alignments and adjustments. And this cell left column is looking pretty good to me. And now in this right-hand column, I'm gonna add all of the information in here. So we're gonna drag in a container, stretch it, remove its background like we did before. And within this container, I wanna go ahead and add our title, the text, make sure the design matches. We'll toss in that paragraph. We'll add another heading in here. Then we'll start adding those images for the static previews. Make some adjustments to it, everything's alignment. We're gonna add these to a stack so that we can fine tune our item spacing. Make sure everything is filling the width. And I think we are in pretty good shape so far. All right, so now we have our dynamic pages set up in Editor X, but the content actually isn't dynamic yet. So that's what we're gonna do now. We're going to take a deeper dive into the Editor X content manager and make sure that we're pulling all of that dynamic information into our portfolio detail page. Let's do that now. All right, so it's time to add some portfolio items to our content manager. But first we need to add some more fields in our database. So we've got our tags here, some extra information about the project. So we want to have enough fields to be able to input all of this information. So I'm going to add a new field called categories. And I'm going to change that to the field type called tags. And we could just write tags like you would normally in another editor. So I'm going to add those tags for each of the items. I'm going to add another field as well. And we're going to call this one something to do with the tech stack. So maybe we'll call it tech stack. And then we'll change this to tags as well and then update the data in each of the items. And we're gonna add another field to our content manager. We're gonna call this one project background. And that's just gonna be text so that we can write out some text. I'm gonna rearrange the table a bit. I'm also gonna add a gallery and change the field type to media gallery. And then we can go ahead and upload all of our images and add all of our data for for each of the individual portfolio items. So I'm just going ahead doing that now, uploading images, adding text, descriptions, tags, and so on and so forth. So now that we have each of the items added to our content manager, it's time to make our website dynamic. So I'm going to show you how to do that now. Select an element you want to make dynamic. Choose this little icon that says connect to data, and it will connect the text or whatever element to your database, but you get to choose which field to connect it to. This one is the title. This one is going to connect to the summary of the portfolio item. These are the tags. So this is going to be categories. And the next one is going to be the text stack, and we'll select that in our database. But you can see here actually that it will automatically sometimes recognize what field you want to connect to. It's kind of smart that way, so it just makes it easier. So now we have dynamic text here in this section. And now this button, we actually need to add a link to the website of this portfolio item. So we need to go back to our content manager and add a new field that will allow us to enter that information. Very simple, just going to add a new field, call that visit website or maybe website URL, change the field type to URL, save that, and now we can just rearrange our table if we wish and add all the information for each of the items. And now we can select our button, connect that to data in the database. It will automatically know which field to choose, and here we go. That link is now updated dynamically. We'll change the text and that should work. Now we'll go ahead, continue adding dynamic information from our database to the rest of the page here. I'm just going to update the title. That's static. We don't need to make that dynamic. This paragraph text is actually the project summary or the project background rather. This title will be called static previews. And then we need to do our gallery. All right, now it's time to add the gallery. So I'm going to delete these static images and I'm going to add a new pro gallery under the media tab. And I'm going to choose stacked, this stacked style gallery, just drag it into where I want it to go, connect it to the data in the data set. I'm going to choose gallery media gallery, the one that we created. Then we can modify some settings in this gallery, spacing, so on and so forth. And now another thing I want to do here is select this gallery. And because we have a width of 100%, I want a max width of 900 pixels because if we have a large screen, we don't want it to get too wide. Let's preview it. Looks like all of our information is dynamically coming in from our content manager. The gallery works. And we're going to check our other items here in our portfolio. All this is being pulled from the content manager and it looks like everything is working perfectly. It's responsive. Everything is going according to plan. All right, so our portfolio detail page is nearly complete. Now we need to add the final touches. Specifically, the navigation at the bottom of those portfolio items, we should be able to navigate to the next and previous items in the database. Let's do that now. All right, so now we have this footer portfolio navigation section. Let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna play around with the hairlines. There's one here, I'm just gonna make it a little bit lighter of a color. I'm also going to adjust these buttons. They're actually dynamic buttons already. It goes to the next and previous dynamic items. I'm just going to modify the layout a bit and the fonts. And then I'm also going to add those other hairlines to match the design. So I'm going to actually duplicate this line, bring it down, align it properly. And then I'm going to actually duplicate this one again to get that vertical centered line. So gonna duplicate, resize, rotate it 90 degrees, make sure the height matches the space in between, put it right in the center. And here we have the preview, it looks pretty good. These previous and next buttons don't really look that right to me. And I'm just gonna actually add a button from the button gallery here, a styled button with an icon. Then I can actually modify this to match the design much better. I'm gonna actually choose a left arrow icon. I'm just gonna search for one. This one works. Then what I can do is actually connect this to the next and previous dynamic items. And the reason why this one is gray is because there is no previous item currently. But when there is a previous item in the list, then it will actually display its color. So now we've got our previous item button. I can go ahead and actually style that to better match the design. I found a little quirk that when there is no previous item, the previous item button is gray to indicate a disabled button, which is good usability, but for some reason I couldn't find a way to override the disabled style. I'm sure there's a way, but I'm okay with this for now. Then I'm gonna go ahead, duplicate the previous button so it matches the style, but I'm gonna change the text, the icon, the position of the icon, the rotation of the icon. And once all of this is done, then I can go ahead and make both of these buttons properly dynamic. I'll connect them to the data to go to the next dynamic page and the previous dynamic page respectively, make some final adjustments to the style, the design to make the buttons match. Then I'm gonna publish this and preview it in my browser. Here we have our dynamic portfolio item page. I'm gonna scroll down. Looks like we have our galleries. Our buttons are working. We're going to the next item here. And now both previous and next buttons are visible. And now we're on the last item coming up here, which will show that the next button should be disabled. This is working. If I go to the portfolio index, we have our index page with our items, which we can select to go to each individual page. All right, so our portfolio website is coming along nicely. We still have to create our contact page and then make the whole thing responsive and mobile friendly. And so if you want to see that video, which is the next in our series, tap the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also join our CreativeX crew. It's our free community for pro designers, developers, freelancers, and no coders, people who build amazing things for the web. Links are in the description below, and I'll see you on the inside, and I'll see you in the next video.